In this video, I'm going to show you how to skin retouch your photos with a single click of a button in Photoshop. Retouch for Me was kind enough to give me these plugins to try out, but this video is not sponsored by Retouch for Me. This video is supported by those of you who have purchased my actions, my presets, and my LUTs. Thank you guys for your support. I really appreciate that. And if you just want to check out my actions, my presets, and my LUTs, I'll put the download links in the description below. With that said, let me just show you how amazing these plugins are. Let's just jump in Photoshop and do some retouching, or let the plugins retouch for us, right? So I'm going to go to my actions. I'm going to click on this action button here. If you can't find it, just go to Window and then select actions here. I'm going to go on my actions and then I'm going to select one click retouch, right? I'm just going to click on it like this. And then I'm going to wait for the action to do its thing, right? Let me just close this. Just one click of a button and then we're here. This is our before, this is our after, this is our before, this is our after. Let me just delete the one click folder like this. Now let me show you how these plugins works. So the first thing that I'm going to do, I'm going to make a copy of this background layer. Command J or Control J on the keyboard, or I'm just going to drag this and drop it on this icon here. The reason why I've done this is because I want whatever I'm going to do to this image to be done on this background layer, right? So I'm going to go to filter here and then I'm going to select retouch for me and then I'm going to select retouch for me here. I'm going to wait for the plugin to do its thing, right? Let me just move this one here so that we can see what's happening here. So when you click on the original here, you see the image, your original image. When you let go, you see the processed image, right? The next thing, you see the sensitivity here. This is where you control how much of the blemishes you want the plugin to remove from the image, right? So if I take it to zero like this, it's not going to do anything, right? But if I take it this side, I'm able to see how much of the blemishes the plugin is going to remove, right? So I'm going to take it to 100% because I want the plugin to remove all the blemishes in this image, right? Let me show you how these icons works. Let's just pretend I decide to keep this blemish, right? I don't want to remove this blemish from the image. So I'm going to select this icon and then I'm just going to paint it like this. So if I click on apply, the plugin is not going to remove this blemish because I've painted on it, telling the plugin to keep this blemish for me. But if I want to remove it, I'm going to select this icon and then I'm just going to paint like this. And then if I click on apply, the plugin is going to remove this blemish as well. This slider here, this is where you control how big you want these icons to be. So if I take it maybe to 50, if I select the eraser icon like this, and then if I just paint like that, the brush is now bigger. If I click on the brush and then I paint like that, the brush is bigger. When we come down here, let me just zoom out. If you are working on a full portrait, you can click on this icon. If you're working on a waist level portrait, you can click on this icon. If you're working on the headshot or close-up shot, you can click on this icon. But I like leaving it at auto. The plugin is going to decide the image for me. So I like just keeping everything at auto. And then I'm going to check on mask. So once I'm done with this, I'm just going to click on apply here. So I'm going to wait for the plugin to remove the blemishes for me. So this is the before, this is the after. Let me just zoom in so that you can see what's happening here. I haven't done anything. I just clicked on the plugin and then it has done all this for me, right? This is the before, this is the after, this is the before, this is the after. The next thing that I'm going to do from here, I'm going to make a visible stamp layer, right? I'm going to hold Control, Shift, Alternate, E on the keyboard. I'm going to go to filter here and then I'm going to select retouch for me and then dodge and burn. So I'm going to wait for the plugin to do the dodging and burning for me. Let me just move this here. Let's make this bigger so that we can see what's happening here. On the warmth, if I take it to 100%, it's going to add some warmth to the image. I don't want that. I'm just going to leave it at zero. On the blend here, if I take it to zero like this, it's not going to do anything. Like no dodging and burning will be done to this image. If I take it to 100%, I think this is too much. The dodging and burning is too much to my liking. So I'm going to take it to 130 works for me. So I'm going to put it at 130. I'm going to check this soft light layer. By default, it's going to come like this. So I'm going to check this and then I'm going to click apply. And then I'm going to wait for the plugin to do the dodging and burning for me, right? So once the plugin is done with the dodging and burning, the image will look like this. So go to blending modes here and then change it from normal to soft light here. This is the before, this is the after, this is the before, this is the after. Let me just zoom it in so that we can see what's happening. This is the before, this is the after, this is the before, this is the after, right? So from here, what I'm going to do again, I'm going to make a visible stamp layer. I'm going to hold Control, Shift, Alternate, E on the keyboard. Once I have a visible stamp layer here, I'm going to go to Filter, Retouch for me, and then I'm going to select Retouch for me portrait volumes. And then I'm going to wait for the plugin to retouch for me. So if you want to see more videos like this one, don't forget to subscribe and smash that bell icon so that when I put up my next video, you will be notified. So it's done. This is a before, this is a after, this is a before, this is a after. So on the blend here, if I take it to zero, you won't see anything. If I take it to 100%, this is too much. This is a before, this is a after. I like it, but I feel like it's too much. So before, this is a after. So I'm going to take it to 130 here. So on soft light layer, I'm going to check this and then I'm going to click on apply like this. So once it's done, the image will look like this. What you need to do from here is go to blending modes here and then change it from normal to soft light. So this is the before, this is the after, this is the before, this is the after. Now I'm going to select the layer which is on top like this, and then I'm going to hold shift on the keyboard, and then I'm going to select the background copy here, and then I'm going to drag this and drop it on this folder icon here. This is our before. This is our after. How cool is this? So let's try these plugins on a dark skin model. If you don't want to do everything that I've done here, I'm going to put the action in the description below. You can download it and use it for free. But for the action to work, you need these plugins. The hue, the dodging and burning, and the portrait volume. The first link that I'm going to put in the video description below, that's where you're going to download these three plugins. After you download the plugins, now you can download the action from my store. You have to load it in your Photoshop. Let me show you how to do that. You have to go on window here and then click on actions here. Go on these four lines and then select load action here. Just look for the folder where you saved the action you downloaded from my store. In my case, my action is here. I can just double click on the action or I click here. The action will be loaded in Photoshop. So I'm going to click on these four lines and then I'm going to select button mode here. So my action panel is going to look like this. So I've loaded the action twice. So it's the same action, but I've just loaded it twice. I'm just going to click on the action here and then it's going to retouch for me. Let me close this. So this is the before, this is the after, this is the before, this is the after. So let's do the same thing even on this image. Let me just zoom out and then I'm going to go to my actions here and then I'm just going to click on one click retouch like this. And then I'm going to wait for the plugins to do its thing. I don't want to spend hours and hours working on one image. It's the reason why I recommend these plugins by Retouch for me, or it's a reason why I always recommend you getting my retouching actions pack, because I don't want you to be spending hours and hours and hours just working on one image, right? So this is the before, this is our after, this is the before, this is our after. They also have something which you can use to make the model's eyes brighter. I don't have those plugins, but I have my actions. So if I want to make the eyes brighter, I can go to my actions here. I can select the teeth and eye whitening. It's going to select the brush for me. Since the layer mask here is black, I'm going to set the foreground color here to white. I'm just going to click on this icon here. And then I'll just paint where I want these eyes to be brighter, right? And then I can reduce the opacity to whatever I'm going to like this. This is a before, this is a after. I feel like there are too much reds in this image, I can just go on my actions here and then I can just select reduce reds here, and then I can reduce the opacity to maybe 35%, and then this is the before, this is the after, this is the before, this is the after. And then if I want to color grade it, I can go again to my actions and then I can select this EK signature golden look. So this is the before, this is the after. If I feel like the effect is too much, I can just reduce the opacity to maybe 40%. This is the before, this is the after, this is the before, this is the after. If you want to retouch fast and level up your retouching skills, you should check out my retouching actions pack. The link will be in the description below. And if you want to learn how to retouch using my retouching actions pack, you should check this video on top. And if you want to learn how to retouch in less than 10 minutes, you should check this video down here.